live from Los Angeles, Sunday, November 7th. RDMJ Soulful Sundays live in SNS Chicago present the SNS Experience, Steve Shukurly's birthday bash, featuring CeCe Peniston, Byron, Stingily of 10 City, Steve Shukurly, David Harness, DJ Skip, Mike Hitman Wilson and Sean Christopher, Mellow Man 8, Carolyn Griffey, Lee Farmer, Randall Dean, DJ 3J, David Sabat, Derek Wise. And special surprise guests you don't want to miss. This event will be hosted by MDoc and George Daniels. Sunday, November 7th, 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. at the Globe Theater. 740 Broadway in downtown L.A. Tickets are available at evenbright.com. And
I can't hear what they're playing.
No, we got dogs that we're trying to keep quiet.
Oh.
Get them settled.
My poor little dog passed away a lot earlier in the year. She was 12. She's my daughter's dog.
Oh.
Yeah, she's had her since she was a baby. I mean, since she was a little one. She was a King Cavalier and poodle, a cabby poo.
Oh.
Yeah, she was cute, little halo.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another edition of We Love Rare Grooves. And tonight, it's a very special edition of We Love Rare Grooves because, you know, usually we're on fire, but the house is going to be on fire tonight here on We Love Rare Grooves. We want to welcome our listening audience all over the globe for joining us tonight. We're coming live from the studios of Burbank, California on the UBN Network Channel 1 and also on our YouTube channel, Facebook, and Twitter. I'm your host, C-Mose. As we do every Monday, we bring you the magic of the music and the music of the magic where the legends live here on We Love Rare Grooves. But I can't do this show without my great cast and crew. As we always say, we can't start it off without the world famous videologist, DJ Reg. What's going on, my good man?
Happy Monday, everyone. How's everybody doing?
Doing great, man. This show is for you from one DJ to another tonight, man.
Yeah, but he plays that beautiful dance music, man. I don't play all that,
I got you. I got you playing house.
Yeah, I play a little. I parlay a little bit.
Got to close the party out with some house.
I can parlay a little bit. I can make it happen.
You can make it happen. Okay.
Yes. Jack your body.
Oh, we can, because it's gonna be a party.
Yeah, it is.
It's going to be a party as we do here every Monday night on We Love Rare Grooves. And then we got my boy over there, the consultant in the house. Yes. What's going on? You got to know your soul. Yes. The music of a lifetime.
There you go. Well, listen, you guys talking about house, but I know of Steve Hurley when he was doing funk, okay? Matter of fact, I got the CD on Tom Joyner. And it was enough where the skunks was saying, hallelujah, we got some funk up in here. And that brother So y'all may know him as the house man. I know him as a brother who just liberated the funks, the skunks, by making everything funky. Looking excited to have him here today. Plus, them lovely ladies. Yeah, okay, we ain't gonna get crazy yet.
But we got one lovely lady. Absolutely. That keeps the glue going. There That's the go. Beautiful, talented. And my girl, the one and only co-host, Miss Shantani Irie.
Hey.
Before this year out, can I get somebody find me? Can I get the sound bite? Somebody. Help a man out.
Anybody. Help a brother out.
What's up?
He'll have it next month.
Right.
Sometime next
wonderful.
Year.
Congratulations. I mean, for the second year in a row, you come up as the best music podcast.
I know we did. The whole show did.
Yes, yeah. So congratulations to all you guys.
And oh, you, are you saying her or everybody?
Yeah.
That's why I said everybody.
I kept on looking. You just had your eyes on one person. What's up with that?
Because he keeps his eyes on the prize.
Yeah, yeah.
There we go. See?
Whoa. Yeah. Tell him about it,
see?
Girl.
That's what,
tell
him about see? It, see? Let's, you got thrown on all
move.
Of us.
Let's
know it's all about her. See? It's all about her.
I'm just kidding.
No, no, no.
I don't want Miss Faye fighting me. Don't fight me,
but I do want to thank our listening audience all over the globe that voted for us. Please.
Definitely appreciate you guys so very much.
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Instagram.
Yeah, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, everything, YouTube. We're all there.
So we want to give a little thanks every week to make it happen. The one and only Beverly Boys Production, the go-to guys for all your video production needs. Give them a call at 1-800. That's right, 1-800-385-1243. That should be etched because they've been with us from the beginning. Then my girl over there at LB Tax Account, all year long tax consulting service. It's about that time again, so she can help you file your taxes, help you get them filed right. Year round tax services. Give her a call, 424-227-8885. And that's right, this Sunday we're coming up with a big birthday bash for Soulful Sunday. That's RDMJ Entertainment with my boy Randy. We get ready to put it together with a great birthday bash at the Globe Theater. Get your tickets, CUS tickets. That's right, get your tickets today for that. But the reason we're doing that is because we have a gentleman tonight that's recognized as one of the pioneers of Chicago house music. I'm talking about his mix shows has been syndicated in 128 stations in the U.S. and over 8 million listeners a week. He has written, remixed, and produced over 400 records, including chart-topping gold and platinum songs from artists like, y'all ready?
We ready.
Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Prince.
Woo!
Yeah. Crystal Waters.
Heard
Madonna,
too.
Madonna.
Yeah.
Yolanda Adams.
Yolanda Adams.
CeCe Peniston.
Mm-hmm.
BoyzIIMen.
Girl, yeah.
Janet Jackson.
Yeah.
Chaka Kahn. Do I got to keep going? And Nesby.
Keep going.
Byron Stingily.
I thought he said Chocolate Kahn. I was like, huh?
Chocolate Kahn.
I thought Chaka was a little bit more beige than chocolate.
I call it, she chocolate than this.
I don't know.
He and DJ Skip have garnered worldwide recognition, and their label S&S Records has produced great artists. So also joining us in studio to help us celebrate what's coming up this weekend, we have the one and only Miss Carrie Lucas of the Solar Records, and also the lovely daughter of her, Carolyn Griffey of Shalamar fame, is still out there with Howard Hewitt making it happen on Shalamar.
Yeah, they are so, in London.
That's right, in London. But tonight is all about my man, Steve Silk Hurley. Welcome to the Groove Studios, my good man.
Hey, what up, bro?
What's up?
What's up? It's a party. Did
What's
somebody
going
kick
on? Glad to be in the house.
Hey man, welcome. Welcome to the Groove Studios. Yes, Carolyn and Miss Lucas. Welcome.
We're ready to jack our bodies. Come on.
Yeah. Go ahead, girl.
Pump it up.
Y'all gotta get me one of them S&S shirts too, man, when you come out this weekend, man.
All right. We got you.
So tonight, man, we're going to go on a musical journey of talking about the music genre of house, but also the things that you've done in R&B music and how you mix all that together, man, and come up with that soulful sound only by Steve Silk Hurley and his S&S Records. But as we do every Monday night, it has to start from the beginning, man. So we're going to start out there from the Chicago, because you're a Chicago native. I got people from Chicago.
Chi-town. Chi-town.
That's right. The Mosleys. That's where I'm from. You heard the Mosleys, right?
I thought the Mosleys was from Louisiana.
Yeah, but we got roots in Chicago.
Oh, okay.
Just a cousin?
They get around.
Yeah, a cousin.
A cousin. He probably a cousin like number four, number five.
Right.
Cousin.
Nim.
Yeah. Cousin Nim.
Take me away, Shanti. You might as well go ahead and give him that question. Could he come out?
Okay, Mr. Silk. Did you come out of the womb on the ones and the twos?
Pretty much. I had that music playing in my head, probably because my dad was an avid
fan of music, so there was always music playing in the house. But I started tinkering around a little bit and figured out that I wanted to be a DJ at some point.
What did your dad play? What was some of the music he played?
He loved playing jazz around the house, like not as a musician, but just listening to it. He had like a stereo system and one of those big old huge console looking things that he told me I couldn't touch. And when he would leave and go to work, I'd be messing with his stuff, and I broke his needles.
He must have broke a couple belts for that one. Good Lord. What about your mother? What about your mom?
Oh, she's just the perfect mom. I mean, like, from a musical standpoint, I don't think she influenced me from that standpoint, but just molded me to be the right type of person. You know, she was just selfless, you know, still is selfless mom, you know, that just, you know, got the back of the family. I used to wake up in the middle of the night, or if I was up practicing DJ, and she'd be down in the basement doing laundry. I'd be, huh? Wait, you do laundry this late? Like, I mean, she was just... She's the first one up and the last one to go to sleep, you know. So, maybe that's where I get some of my hard work from. Her and my dad, you know.
What was the first instrument they had you learn how to play?
I played trumpet because my brother had played trumpet, and then he quit, and we had a trumpet. So I was like, I'll play trumpet.
So I'll take it.
Looks kind of fun until my lips start getting sore, and you know, man, that was. I mean, I had a good ear for it, but I didn't want to learn all those little fingerings and things like that. So I started messing around with the piano a little bit, but never really took it serious.
Did they make you take lessons, piano lessons?
I actually asked to take lessons, but I wasn't like a hard worker. I was too spaced out, you know, thinking about something creative, like always thinking like, man, I like that song, but what if I, you know, I would try to come up with something. So I didn't really like the structure of the lessons, you know. It just was, it wasn't my kind of thing, you know. It took me a while to figure it out. I actually found out that I was musically inclined through DJing. You know, DJing actually taught me how to be a better music producer and songwriter and everything, because I really didn't learn how to produce till after I was a DJ and after I mastered that.
Now, were you a DJ in high school?
In my senior year, I started DJing what we call sock hops.
And,
we had these big blue turntables with the speakers on the side, and we took a microphone and go from one turntable to the other with the microphone, and that's how we mixed. So it was horrible, but it was better than anybody else was doing. So
there you go.
I took that and I learned how to select music at that point, what people like to hear. Mostly from borrowed records. You know, I had a partner that had a few records that he borrowed. I borrowed some from my dad that he didn't know. Some my brother's record. I had my brother's my brother loved Ronnie Laws. That's
Ronnie's been on the show.
It's funny you say that, because Ronnie's supposed to call in tonight.
Yeah, he's been on twice.
He got a new release out. I forgot it. Right.
Eloise.
Now you had your one brother who played the trumpet. Any other siblings that were musically inclined?
My younger sister, who's 5 years younger than me, she's the next one in line. There's four of us, and she actually had the talent to learn and the patience to learn how to play. So she actually became pretty good at the piano. So she was lapping me on the piano, but then I got focused on the DJing. And just, you know, learning how to, I was intrigued by the fact that you could mix records together, because when I found out about it, only station that was doing that was Disco DAI in Chicago, 1977, 78.
Right.
A guy named Kenny Jason, I heard him on there, and Pino Wiki mixing like Donna Summer records and Stephanie Mills, and a lot of disco stuff, but soulful disco I was attracted to. So, when I saw that they could mix the records and make them be a continuous thing, it wasn't something that people were really doing, you know, I wanted to learn that, and I didn't have the equipment for it. So I got the wrong equipment. I was hooking up the wrong stuff. I went through a real struggle with that, you know, learning how to become a DJ and how to get the equipment, built myself a turntable case, had belt drive turntables instead of.
I started with a belt drive. BIC.
Yeah.
Turntable.
Yeah.
You know about that, huh?
B1s. Right. SLB One Nation, baby. That's where SLB One.
Now,
then I had the eight. Then I had the 1800s, the SL 1800s. And then
man,
the other, you know, when I try to tell people that, you say I'm talking about DJ talk. The thing is, a lot of the DJs didn't know how to do it, which I knew how to do was read that scope before we had the other thing we have now. You had to know how to read that scope and put songs together.
Plus 3.3.
Yeah, but you had to turn that little knob just a tad and read the scope. Yeah.
Now tell me this. I'm going to ask our guest that's supporting you tonight. When the first time,
Ms. Lucas, strobe, they call it.
When was the first time you got what was the first DJ you know of, Ms. Lucas? Who would you say was your first DJ experience that you knew that DJ by now?
Probably Frankie Crocker, the New York rocker.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Wow. How about you, Carolyn?
Good old friend.
Who would be your first?
Steve.
Steve.
Good answer.
What a great! I'll pay you later for that.
Uh-huh. Right. And Steve, what
but
is?
I mean, but you know what? It's kind of hard for me growing up in it because I mean, my memory doesn't serve me as well as my history, you know, it serves itself. But I mean, it's kind of different too because when you're in the industry. You don't even realize the greatness that you're around because Steve and I actually, we have so many, if we didn't meet one way, we would have met another way.
Okay.
Because, you know, we are connected through so many different parts. But the funny thing is, it's kind of like my daughter. One time she asked me, go, Mom, do you know anybody famous? And I'm like, all her aunts and uncles, it's like, you don't think about it, but it's like, you know, Steve, I really didn't even realize as when I met Steve, his body of work. And then one day, I'm sorry, I have to admit, one day I just got real, you know, real stalkerish and I kind of did like the Google. And that's what was the Google people you know. You Google people you don't know. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I really almost kind of felt foolish because I didn't even realize how, I mean, when you grow up with legends, and I don't mean to sound cocky, you don't look at them as legends until you get seasoned. And so when I started reading, I was like, whoa. So I really didn't want to act like a fan, but I guess I'm here.
Now. Right.
Hey, I appreciate the love.
So I'm having to play it cool, but I mean, I just really just seriously amazed at the body of work. I mean, how many artists, how many albums, how many genres he spreads across, you know? I mean, how do you go from CeCe Peniston to Ann Nesby to Ashanti? I mean, it's vast and I've learned to have a new respect for DJs, especially now with the legacy and seeing what they do, how they give new life to records, to artists that, you know, and you learn because, you know, traveling in Europe and going all over the world, you come home and nobody even looks at you. But when I go overseas, it's so funny. We can't go overseas and not hear Solar. And not hear SNS and not hear, I mean, when I learned too, the magnitude of what you guys do, you and Skip over there, I mean, 40,000, 70,000 plus, it's like raves here. It's, you know, it's just, it's mind blowing. So I get a little overwhelmed thinking about it. So I'm excited that they even invited us.
So Steve, tell us, what was your first mix hit? I'm talking about not for that you said, bam, I'm there. What did you mix as the first one? And I'm saying the first, not the first one, but the first one that came across big and said, damn, I'm happening.
You know what? It's funny, when I was doing this for fun in my mom and dad's house in the bedroom, my first record that I did was Music is the Key, which was one of the first house music records. And, you know, that gave me a good feeling, but you're talking about more like remixing when I built that name. It took me from 84, 85 all the way to, I would say, 88 to really start embracing my sound as a sound.
Mm-hmm.
So it would probably be the Roberta Flack, Look Out Here It Comes, because it was a R&B record produced by Quincy Jones with all the best musicians ever assembled, Greg Filling Gaines and just all kind of people on that record. And I did a remix. I took like 3 or 4 days trying to mix these 72 digital tracks and trying to figure out how I was going to do something that would make Quincy Jones proud, you know, like
So
and I didn't really come up with anything that I like, and then at the last minute I said, you know what, I got back from, I had to go to Milwaukee to mix that because it was on some special tape that Quincy had, 72 tracks, so you know, that's like some crazy stuff. So I went back, instead of going home, I went to the studio. I said, I'm gonna just do a house mix when I get back because I gotta get this thing turned in tomorrow. And I stayed up all night and did a house mix of it. And I didn't use any of the instruments. All I used was the percussion because the percussion was so good. And I made some loops from it and I created my own track to her record, and it was totally different. It was an R&B contemporary record, about, you know, 60 or 70 beats per minute, and I made it like 120, and it went number one on the dance charts, and she ended up putting it on her greatest hits later on. So that one is kind of monumental to me because it made me realize that I could be myself and just act like I'm collaborating on a remix instead of taking what's there and kind of just rearranging it or changing the drums or something like that and just making it danceable, actually adding new music. That and Jamanda, Got a okay. Love For You. Those two okay. are really kind of like transform the records, especially Jamanda. So one is, they both mean something okay. to me for more than one reason, but those are some of the earlier ones where I realized that I actually had a sound, because if you look back at my earlier records, Jack Your Body was like an anomaly. It was something I did for fun, and it ended up being big, but it wasn't for somebody else. It was more right, just something that I just did off the dome.
On the south side of Chicago, over there on 88th Street or somewhere.
Yeah, 89th and Blackstone.
Yeah, I was close.
Yeah, you're close.
So we're going to do this. We're going to go back and see if, you know, you said this is the early, so we think we get back, we feel we might be a little early, so check this out, what we found here, because that's why they call us Rare Grooves. We go down there in the groove studios, down in the basement, down in the vault. So check this out. Give us a call, 323-524-2599. Speak with the one and only Steve Silk Hurley. We're streaming live on the UBN Network, Channel 1, Facebook Live, Twitter, and Periscope.
We're going to go live, so we're going to mute your microphones, okay, Periscope. Guys? So we're going to have you muted until we come back on air.
So check these out and see if we went back in the Groove Studios and found something for you, Steve.
All right.
Pretty Tony. DJ Reg, take me away. We'll be back in a house minute, baby, here on We Love Rare Grooves.
Commercial.
Right.
You want to do that? No, I'm just saying, you want to do the commercial or you want to do the music?
Mute them.
Oh, shoot.
I said, we're grooveless. We can't hear the grooves, right?
Oh, I wonder what it is. Are they live?
Let's get it. 107 FM, AM My name's Dave Patterson. I'm a Seattle area videographer. I've been working with Beverly Boy Productions for over 2 years, and I can say they are great to work with. They've always provided me with the information I need so that when I show up on set, I can shoot exactly what's necessary to tell the story the client is trying to tell. Call sheets that include the who, what, why, where, when of the video shoot, production notes, gear requirements, crew requirements, load-in time, all that. Makes my job a lot easier, and ultimately it produces the results that the client's going to be happy with. This is what a professional company like Beverly Boy Productions does, and also it's one of the reasons why I really enjoy working with them. It's a bit of a family vibe. They're very low-key, low-pressure, but they're very professional at the same time, and they get the results, and that's ultimately what matters most. I'm proud to be a shooter for Beverly Boy Productions, and if you're looking for a company to produce your next video production, by all means, give them a call. They can handle any sort of scale project from a single-person interview to a large production with multiple cameras and large crews. You won't be disappointed with the results. Give them a call.
Tonight, we in the house studios here and UBNGo.com. We love rare grooves. I'm your host, C. Mose, in the house with Steve Silk Hurley, and joining him for this birthday bash is coming up, Carrie Lucas and Carolyn Griffey. So as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves, we go into the groove yard. Did we go into the groove yard, Mr. Hurley, Mr. Silk?
Yeah, y'all went way back, didn't you? They went back into the bedroom tapes. That first one was one of the 1983-84 remake of Isaac Hayes' I Can't Turn Around. It didn't come out till 2 years later. So,
nice.
That's what we did.
And the Shadows of Your Love was like taking me back to when we used to go perform at the Paradise Garage and Zanzibar.
Yes, 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 indeed. Yep. I had a minute exploring that.
Yeah.
So before we get, I want to get into the music, but I want to share something with you. And when you talk about house music, we got to talk about Frankie Knuckles. But I found something here, and this is how you kind of mix and splice tapes. And I just want to take about 30 seconds if this video, Pretty Tony, you had that for me. And this is something, and I want to discuss too, kind of the origins of house music and your thoughts on that. And as we continue here on We Love Rare Grooves, Pretty Tony, just let's throw that up there for a minute on.
Trying like re-editing or remix them is what I thought I was doing with them, to keep their interest, because I figured there wasn't that much new music coming out.
So show me. Because this is one of the tracks you used to use, right?
Yeah, this is a real big classic.
Eddie Kendricks.
Uh-huh. You about to mark the tape right now.
Uh-huh.
Oh, he got a reel-to-reel?
Uh-huh.
That's how we did it.
That's why I wanted to conversate. I just wanted
to... reel-reel. Wow.
Oops. Ow. Every good DJ scratches a record every now and then.
Yeah, somebody bump your table too.
A couple times and extend it, and then just let it end the way it naturally does. So really, the only thing I did was I changed the intro and I changed the middle.
Right.
I mean, if you were listening very closely, you know, sometimes what they were singing didn't really make sense. But it would play tricks on people's, you know, hearing when they're on the dance floor, because they think they know that they know the song, and it'll start singing one particular way. All of a sudden, it would go in another direction.
So
still the same song, but lyrically.
So this is kind of where that beginning mix, and I just wanted to kind of share this with you, Steve, and let you talk about how you engaged in that part of developing the music from that type of sound, from what Mr. Frankie Knuckles, and we can get into the Godfather and the Prince and the King of House Music.
When did Frankie Knuckles start, like 73?
What'd you say?
When did Frankie Knuckles start doing anything, like 73? Is that when he came around, or...?
No.
Well, yeah, I mean, as far as DJing, I think he did start DJing probably 70. I'm not sure. I thought I heard 77, but right. I don't want to put the date on it.
Right.
But I know it was the 70s.
So. It's like hip hop. We can't put that date on when did hip hop really start. Yeah. You know what I mean? They still trying
to
find
it. Started in the Bronx, that's all.
Right, and trying to put that date behind it.
And it started in rap.
I mean, I discovered that you could mix records in 78, 79, so you know, that's when my journey started. So I could kind of talk about that. Like, one of the reasons house music was born is because we wanted to do re-edits of records using the best parts of the old disco records and looping them, which was kind of akin to what hip hop was with the break beats, but for us with house, it was us looping the end of the song that nobody knew about, the part that was just the catchiest part, you know. Even one of Carrie Lucas's songs, "The Dance With Me," has like a crazy part at the end. I can't wait till we're re-releasing her record, and we're gonna have some of those parts in there. Like, so it's kind of like the same concept as hip hop, like I was saying, like where you take the best part of the record and then you combine it. What we were doing back then, we were re-editing it, and I started out doing pause button mixes with cassettes. So I did it with cassette, but it wasn't as accurate as I wanted it to be. So then I learned about tape early on, and I got a reel-to-reel, and I was doing exactly what Frankie was doing on that tape. That's how I would do my edits. I started doing the edits on there. If I couldn't take the two records and go back and forth like this, and go back and forth from turntable to turntable and beat juggle it, then I would layer that over drum machines. I did everything I could do with what I had, because I didn't really have
a whole lot of
equipment for creating music.
Now, did you at what age did you realize that this is what you wanted to do for a living, as opposed to, I don't know, going to work at the post office or something?
I would say when I won DJ battle.
Like, and that make a career out of
fourth,
it.
I won like a third or fourth DJ battle in like 82. And it gave me the opportunity to spin for the house music crowd. Because at that point, we didn't have a house genre, but we had a house music culture of people that liked music that had a certain vibe. And we decided to start making our own music. But before we started making our own music, I won that battle in 82. And we started creating our own music in like 83, 84. You know, re-edits, and then it turned into using drum machines. Then we started making our own thing. So, what was your question?
Age? How old were you when you realized that you wanted to do this for a living?
Well, I didn't, just being honest, I didn't take life that serious. I was like finally doing something that I love to do, because I couldn't concentrate in school. I didn't find the stuff that I was learning in school to be important. It didn't make sense to me, like to learn about things that I wasn't going to use. So when I started learning music and I started seeing, you know, rewards coming from it, I was like, oh, that's, but then I started getting a fondness for learning everything. So then I was wishing I could go back to school, but it was too late to go back to school because my music took off. So, I got a chance to go back for a little while, but then, you know, when my records started taking off, that's when I was able to kind of focus. But what you asked me, how old? I was 20. I was probably 20 when I won the DJ battle. So I didn't realize that I was going to do music for a living until my records came out in 84, 85, and it hit the Billboard charts. The Music Is the Key hit, and we started doing shows. I was like, wait a minute, I might be able to quit my job soon. And then I eventually was able to, because I wrote that song in the bathroom stall at work. Music Is the Key. I was like, I don't feel good. I went in there and I sat on the john. It was just like writing the lyrics. Music is the key to set yourself free from violence, drugs, and increasing poverty. Like, cause
I
had like,
I understand, son. Yeah. I understand.
So I couldn't wait every day. I was watching that clock every day for 4:30. So, you know, when I saw a window to get out, I got out, and whether it meant a struggle or not, I was ready to just let the job go and just
What were you doing?
I was working for the City of Chicago Public Works Department. It was called an engineering technician, but it sounds fancier than what it really is, because we used to like dig up the rocks. We would get samples of the rocks that they would put down on the roads before they put the concrete down. So they had to be at a certain specification. like each rock, it had to be like a certain number of rocks this size, a certain number of this size, a certain number of that size.
That's a
so we were running like little tests through these machine that would go through sieves and tell you whether they were up to spec.
So he must have been doing good.
Yeah, somebody had
it. He quit a good government. Job, right? He quit a good government city job, a government job.
Government job.
No, the checks ain't gonna bounce.
The problem was it wasn't really paying because I didn't have a degree. So because remember I stopped school, so I was only had a ceiling. I think I was making $11,000 a year back then. So hey, and I had a, if I worked really hard, I could maybe get to 13. So
but at least you had a car. I hope you had a car.
Yeah, I did. Actually, I did have a car. No, but that's how I got my car. So you know, everything has its purpose. You know, like all the things. I worked at a grocery store. I worked at, early on. I had a paper route. I shoveled snow. I mean, I did whatever I had to do to make money.
Man, we got something in common, bro. We got something in common. Yeah.
You didn't have a car, but your boy had a car, right? So your early influences. About that.
When I didn't have a car to drive to my gigs, I had a guy at ET that he used to drive me some places. You know, different people used to help me out at times, you know, with getting a ride or sneaking me out the house. I really did have to sneak out the house to go to the parties because I worked at the grocery store on night shift early on, like when I was started getting in on the scene. And I worked overnight sometimes. So sometimes I would say I was working overnight, but really I would get on the 26 bus. You know what the 26 bus is, right?
Right. We know the bus. We know the bus.
Yeah, 26 all the way to 22nd to go to Sawyer's to go to a party, like just to because my father said no public parties. And, you know,
oh, wow.
He was very, you know, he had his master's in engineering, so he was like, you know, he was all about school, and he didn't understand why I couldn't focus in school because he felt like I was smart enough to do it. Mm-hmm. Which might have been the case, but I just didn't have an interest in that particular thing.
What did your folks say when you quit your good government job to go do music full time?
They didn't quite understand it, but actually, there's a story that's even crazier. When I won the DJ battle, it gave me the opportunity to win to be able to DJ at the place Sawyer's, which was the hot spot. So I had a gig where I was going to make like $50, which is a lot of money back then, mm-hmm. I guess, for DJs. But and I was about to go do that gig, and my father's like, "Nope, you're not doing any public parties." I was like, "I just won a DJ battle, and now I have the opportunity to DJ for the people, you know, that I've been trying to get to, you know, that want to hear the music, you know." So he didn't get it, and he said, "Well, if you don't like my rules, you can get out." And I was like, "All right, I'm out." And then I moved out. Didn't have a dime, didn't have nothing, you know, no transportation. Somebody had to pick me up to take me to the sound man's house because he was cool. He was like a big brother to me. His name is Frenchie. And he was gracious enough to let me stay in his basement. And it wasn't in a great neighborhood. So my family was concerned. My mom and dad was concerned. My brother and sisters. 2 weeks later, my brother and sister came there and said, "Mom and Dad want you to come home." We talked to them. We negotiated you 2:00 to come in. You can come in 2 a.m. You can DJ. So you can DJ. You can DJ the party because I had already DJed that party, and that $50 was long gone. So I didn't mind going back home, you know, because times was getting a little bit rough over there.
So now we're going to go into our next musical selection, and we're going to come back and talk about some of the artists that you had definitely encountered. And then DJ Reg, you guys going to collaborate on how it was in the beginning DJing to how you can do things now. But we're going to go in. Miss Lucas, you guys were talking about collaborating on a song. So we're going to play one of the songs of Carrie Lucas that you're thinking about putting a mix together. And you can tell us, what do we have on here, DJ Reg? What song will we be playing by Miss
Carrie? Are you over here right now?
Well, I just want to know what song, and then we're going to kind of...
Called Dance With You.
Dance With You. So is that something you guys looking to collaborate with?
Yep. Already started.
All right. Well, we're going to give the original...
Already in the works.
Well, we're going to look forward to here's the original of it, and then when we come back, we'll talk about how that song was... How you brought that song out back in, I think, 76, and then see what the new collaboration will be. as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves. Give us a call at 323-524-2599. Streaming live on the UBN Network Channel 1, Facebook Live, and Twitter. Look at pretty Tony over here. He feeling that beat right there.
This is his era. You know, he was in the clubs. You know what he was doing in the clubs with this
They
music.
Ain't have house music in Kansas.
No, we don't.
That's cold. They did. He probably had a transistor radio. He could listen.
Music. I just want to know how Steve, why you still look so young? You're talking about mixing records in 78, and I'm still playing with Legos.
Man,
I just said that. I said he's fine. I don't know how old he is, but he is fine. I did just say that.
She's talking about somebody called him. Somebody said you was fine for what?
Hold on, but somebody told me yesterday, said, man, beige don't age.
Oh, get out of here.
Somebody told me beige don't age. They also was calling you cat daddy over here, too, and shit. They was calling you a cat daddy, too, Steve.
I don't know what the black don't crack, but beige don't age.
No, he looks too young to be a cat daddy. He got a baby face. Nah, cat daddies is like them old. No, he looks like, you know.
Cat daddy. Hey, take me away on some Carrie Lucas, huh? What you say, Steve? Take me away.
No. What's the secret, man? What's the secret of, you know, the fountain of youth? What's the secret?
He drank cat.
Oh, he plays ball. See, that's there you go.
You play ball, man. When you come out here, you want to hoop on Sunday?
Yeah, please.
Let's do it, bro.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Please don't hurt him.
Don't hurt him. We need him.
We need him.
I got the good old man's game. Yeah.
Pick and roll.
Don't hurt him, Steve. We need him. Don't hurt him.
Yeah, you go. Wait a minute.
Let's go on to some Carrie Lucas, man. Y'all get
the knees are out of warranty, but I figured
out. Thank you. honey's packing me. Some light honey's looking proper by the moonlight. Plus, I got attention because I came into the room right. Forget the cliche and the he say, she say. Walk over to the sound booth and whisper to the DJ. And yo, he know the routine because I'll be coming too clean. Plus, I got my eye on honey chilling in the blue jeans. Of course, I'm the Mac and she's looking like the mattress. Halle Berry, Jada Pinkett looking kind of actress. Brothers try to run game, but bust it, this man's the winner. I get the digits dance once and make plans for dinner. It's funny trick with honey dip, I had to move on. People clear the dance floor so we can get our groove on. I wanna dance for one night and party till the sunlight. With the cliches, the catchy words and innuendos, we kick the type of shit that blow the glass right out your blast, 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 right out your blast.
Welcome back to the Groove Studios. I'm your host, C. Mose, in the house with the Groove team. That's right, DJ Raz, the consultant Robert A., Shantani Irie, and we're with our host getting ready to come up with the Sunday, Soulful Sunday birthday bash for the one and only Steve Silk Hurley. We get ready to turn L.A. into the house town on Sunday night. Am I saying that right? We're going to be at the Globe Theater. We're going to have all the special guests. Right. We're going to have Carrie Lucas in the house. That's right. We're going to have Carolyn Griffin in the house. We're going to have your boy Brian from 10 City, CeCe Peniston, DJ Skinny going to be in the house, but I know that ain't his name, though. What's your boy's name? DJ
Skinny.
No.
Yo, he's Skip.
Skip. I was thinking about Skinny Black. I was thinking about Skinny Black from Hustle and Flow.
I'm over you.
Hey, man, we started off, so you guys are getting ready to collaborate on a song with Carrie Lucas. I can see how you're going to turn that around. When is that going to be released?
I would say early next year.
Early next year? Okay.
Yeah. We're in the studio getting it done now. So
what are y'all working on, a whole collection of you, or is this going to be a single release?
That's going to be a single release, but who knows? You know, you never know what might come to be.
Mm-hmm. And with a family royalty.
We definitely want to, we want to shine a light on that song because a lot of people don't know. They're familiar with that music, but more so from, another record that sampled it. And nobody from this generation really knows like the importance of the original record, so we want to shine a light on that and do a new take on it, and, do a more contemporary version that the Generation Z's can comprehend.
And that's been one.
What's special for me about it too is I didn't even I kind of stepped away for a while I was really in this industry for a long time, back behind the scenes and also as an artist. And this particular song was written by one of my late husband's, Dick Griffey's, best friend. And he grew up with him in Nashville. And when we started the record company, a lot of his family and good friends were writing music. And this was one of the songs. And I recorded it. And it did pretty good, but it was just so funny because after it had been released and out for a long time, my daughter and some friends would tell me, there's someone that redid your song. And I was in Santa Monica. You know, yeah. I was in Santa Monica Promenade, and I was in a store, and I'm sitting here, and I just said, "That's my mother's song." And I called. I said, "Did we get licensing on this?" Because I had never heard of it, and I loved it. But you know what? And then after that, we kind of just
But I started looking on YouTube, and I it was even funnier for me, Steve, the comments, you know, they write under the music when Carrie Lucas is stealing his song.
Wow.
She should be ashamed. And I mean, it was funny on the one hand.
Who is this Carrie Lucas?
Who is this Carrie?
Lord have mercy.
Wow.
And I mean, really, well, they say imitation is the best form of flattery.
She was being sweet. I wanted to fight.
Oh, yeah,
Carolyn. Right.
but it was really a thrill, and it was a huge hit in the person and in the genre.
Who version was it? Because it was sampled almost 30 times.
Yeah.
Oh, was it?
Uh-huh.
Armand
Van Helden. Yep.
Armand Van Helden.
And I forgot the guy who was saying it.
But check this out. The funny thing is what nobody realizes, maybe you as DJs do, but I do because it's our music. The first part of that, the first part of the sample that comes in before the song drops is Babyface, It's No Crime. That beat. So when you go back and listen to it, look at his face.
Remember.
Go back and listen to it. It's Babyface's It's No Crime. The beat, the basic beat of it is what they sampled in the beginning before they drop Dance With You.
And now remember.
You need to be working in sample clearances.
Remember, Carolyn.
Like for me, it's almost like a nerve. When I hear things, I can pick it under. You know, of course, having a mom and a dad like Dick Griffey, who could hear, I mean, he could be on an airplane and hear something on the ground. But I mean, it's almost like a nerve that sticks you when you hear it. It's
well, just, remember, you know, right. Carolyn, your best revenge is your paper. So while though they may be asking who your mother is, the bank and the licensees is going to answer that question for
but,
you. So.
But that makes the assumption, though, that someone is paying attention because we've had so many people.
And but you know what? That's twofold because where Steve and Skip have come in is the fact that weren't getting the paper. They were you know what, I'll for the sake of being conciliatory, they had basically tried to commandeer it and erase her from it. And their thing was, you know what, we feel that as artists and everything else, we don't want to see her disrespected and we want to give her her roses while she's still here. So instead of being nasty and getting into some fight or everything else, they're just like, it was a blessing for them to say that because they came to her and was like, we kind of really want to restore you. We want to restore it back to you for you. So, I mean, who does that?
And it's a great honor. I mean, can I say, Steve, and we love Rare Grooves, everyone. It's an honor for me to sit here with my daughter. We are working on legacy projects right now. Uh-huh. But it's such an honor. I mean, Steve, I said Frankie Crocker, the New York rocker, was one of the early DJs. But, you know, I'm so familiar with your work with Tom Joyner and so many different. And you worked with so many wonderful and incredible artists. It's an honor for me to be able to. You know, it's like another record. It's not even almost a remix. I mean, the re-editing, I know it's going to be a completely different record, but with the bass and really giving credit to the writer. I love from the old school. We used to do the albums and you could read everybody.
Right. That's why. Name, yes. Right.
Musician, right. Producer.
Right. Yeah.
This is an incredible opportunity to give to revisit their talent and those artists, those writers, and give them credit as well. So it's a big thank you.
Well, that's why a lot of the generation nowadays doesn't know who did what.
Know.
Because same thing when I was coming up, the producers, the songwriters, that's how you knew how many songs Valerie Simpson and all them wrote. You knew because you were reading the books. You were like, they wrote this too? Yeah.
Absolutely. But you know what the sad part is? The enthusiasm, well, we rarely, unfortunately, unless you're in a small music community, see it here.
Yeah.
But overseas, I mean, it's funny. People will come and tell you who played percussion
on
your records.
Right.
They know.
Right, and we kind of lost that here because that's how we grew up, as we all are talking about on the show. We kind of lost that with the music and treasuring the music that way. We don't treasure it the same way in the United States. And that's a conversation for another time.
But that's why we exist. That's why we exist.
Yeah.
Is to bring that back. Because the amount of people who have been on our show and who've gone deep into their history, it kind of really helps us as well as our audience understand the birth of the music.
And we do it every week. We had Bill Curtis on from the Fatback Band, and he took notes right from the, and he took notes of people that he didn't know that his song had been sampled. He has a legacy that people don't even realize, and we were so happy.
Yeah, most
to
of
give
the
it
artists,
to,
the original, they don't know.
They don't know.
Right,
yeah.
And that's what this show has been able to do. That's why I was able to tell you how many people have sampled your song, and we look forward for you guys coming back, because we're going to give you some things you probably may not have known. We had Dionne Warwick here. Dionne was like, I didn't know this person had sample my song. Please give this to my people so they can research it. But as we continue here on We Love Rare Grooves, we're going to come back. We got Shantani in 60 seconds for Steve. And you guys listen to it too, because when y'all come back on, y'all going to have to be ready in 60 seconds. She's going to have a rapid questions for you, Steve. Then we're going to talk about some of the people that you actually met, come encounter to as you played their music. But we're going to go into our third sample so we can kind of stay within the time. So we have another segment here, segment three. We're just going to jam on some more house music. So get your tickets today, though, because we're going to be partying this Sunday.
Absolutely.
At the Globe Theater for the S&S Experience Steve Hurley Birthday Bash with all the friends are in town, in-house. Get your tickets today at ctickets.us. That's right. We'll call the Globe Theater downtown Los Angeles. We're going to party from 9. They say to 4, man. I ain't been up since the pandemic. I ain't stayed up too late. So I don't know if I can hang past the 4 o'clock. But I know
I'm
used to
get there early.
Get there, yeah, I'm going to have to be there early, man. I'm going to have to get there early. But
I
remember
that show going. We're going to get that show going pretty early because we got a pretty good lineup. You know.
Oh, the show going to start at 9 o'clock.
So 9 o'clock,
the show going to start.
You might want to get there early just so you can catch the whole show.
Okay, get there early, everybody. So get your tickets today. That's right. As we do here on We Love Rare Grooves, we should have some tickets to give away for the next caller. I'll pay for them because I ain't heard from Randy. I'll go ahead.
I'm sure
we'll
we
take it.
Away.
We can give some away. All right, the next caller.
Yeah,
then we're gonna go, let's give some
let's
tickets
give some
away.
Away. Yeah, right. Yeah. Let's give them away, man. Let's give them away.
Next caller.
And they gonna come looking for you, and they're like, I don't know who you are.
No,
just that's it.
DJ Raz, go ahead, man. Take me away to some more music from Steve, Silk Hurley, S&S Records. And in the house is Carrie Lucas, Carolyn Griffin. We going to have a party. We'll be right back. That's my song right there, boy.
Wait, didn't we bump this when she was on here?
Oh, yeah, we bumped this hard when she was on here.
Yeah.
I had like 5 different versions of it, Steve. You did like 100 different versions. You know, he do the extended, the remix, the soulful mix, the house mix, the give it to your daddy mix. It'd be like 100 different mixes, boy.
Hey, man. Yeah, all them ideas, you got to get them out.
So you did you have her, because I was listening to her and I said, if you had her in the studio, you brought this out with her, because a lot of people didn't know she had this, the octaves like this when she was hitting that. You brought it out, huh?
Yeah.
Talk to me.
Oh, my thing cut off. Uh-oh.
Did it? We got it.
Oh, his video.
His video cut off. But you can still talk, though, right?
Yeah.
We can still hear?
It says my video is on. That's all right.
Don't worry about it. We can see you.
We're getting straight.
Right.
We can hear you.
We can hear you, though. Act like we can see you while you talking, but we...
Oh, wow.
Uh-oh, we got...
Okay.
Stay with us.
Are you... Am I actually coming in, or is it the computer doing it?
Yeah, just talk to us.
The audio is...
Okay, cool, yeah. Oh, by the way, we can give away 2 pairs of VIP tickets.
All right.
The VIP, yeah.
2 pairs, okay. Hey, we got a caller? You see, when you said 2 pairs, there you go. We got a caller right now. Who we got on the line?
Thank you for calling We Love Rare Grooves. Who do you have on the line?
Tanya Matthews.
Well, hello.
Hi, Tanya. You don't sound like you in the house studios. What's going on, girl?
Hey, what's going on, you guys?
Good.
Hey, we good. How you doing?
Hey, it's all good. All good. Just trying to check in. And
you enjoying the show?
Participating. Yeah, absolutely.
Uh-huh. So I guess you calling in for some tickets then, if you listening.
I am calling in some tickets. I would love to go participate and hang out over there. Steve's so curly in the house.
All right.
Okay.
So it's this Sunday at 9 o'clock at the Globe Theater. You gonna come? We gonna party.
Okay.
You ready? You a house head? Okay. If you ain't a house head, then
stay home.
That's cold. Damn, he's scaring away your guests. Damn, it's cold blooded.
They call in and you run them away.
Okay.
I'm here. I'm in the house.
All right. So, Tanya, you called the show before, haven't you?
Is
this your first time calling? You talking? All right. Cool. So, we're going to do is make sure you give the engineer your information, and we will get your name, and we will put it on the guest list for you and the guests for this Sunday night at the Globe Theater, the birthday bash with Steve Silk Hurley. I mean, you're going to have the stars in the house. CeCe Peniston, Carolyn Griffey, Carrie Lucas, 10 City is in the house. Who else is going to be in the house, man?
Steve?
Steve?
Oh, man. Derek Wise, DJ Skip, Mellow Man Ace is coming through to drop a few. We got some special guests also coming out. M-Doc is hosting. One of my collaborators on Keep On Walking, and artist in his own right.
Keep on.
Of course,
okay.
Carolyn and Carrie.
Oh,
man,
wow.
I had to call Howard Johnson and Mr. So Fine. I said, "Come on, brother." I didn't even get it out my mouth. He was like, "I'm coming."
You know who else is coming?
Who?
You? Sonny from La Louisiana.
Oh my God, stop it. Oh my God.
Sonny's going to be there.
That's an inside joke. But if you're in La Louisiana. Hey, Tanya, we're going to see you on Sunday. Yeah. We got your information.
You guys
going
to see me on Sunday.
You got what?
I said, you guys going to see me on Sunday.
Which is smooth.
And we got your information.
Sounding
Thank
smooth,
you so much for calling in.
She's sounding smooth, Steve. Better watch out, Steve.
She calling sounding smooth because Steve is in. She saw the video of her. So she had to put that voice on. I understand, Tanya. Right. I understand.
She said she like cat daddies.
Oh, my God.
All right, Tanya, thanks
you.
So
have
much.
A great day.
Beige don't crack. Beige don't fade.
Steve, you
don't
know
age at all.
Now, Steve, you know I see your miseducation on Lauryn Hill in the back. You know I was going to say something about it.
All right.
I see it you in the back. Know? Yeah, let's tell us about that right quick.
What's crazy is when we were out there performing at the Sensations out in New Jersey as JM Silk, and we used to perform Jack Your Body too. And what I heard, Lauryn Hill used to be there, and so did Biz Markie, mm-hmm. and so was Queen Latifah. Like that was like their hangout. And she ended up wanting to use Jack Your Body on one of her songs on there, like just actually saying Biz used to rock the party, Jack Your Body. I forgot the name of the song.
Every ghetto, every city is the song.
Jack your body. So that was real cool of them to go on and take care of that and not, you know, not do me like a lot of the artists, you know, get done. Like, you know, yeah. they just take their stuff and don't even.
You got your receipts, you know, like pay. We say here.
Right. That's yeah. what we say. Get your receipt.
So I appreciated that on their behalf, on the label's behalf and on her behalf. Yeah, because I think on the album before that, the Fugees album, I think they had some issues with a lot of sample clearances. So mm-hmm. they were on it on that album that I heard, they cleared every single sample. They were like, hey, I hear a hi-hat. Where'd that come from?
Right.
Like, so they weren't playing.
Wow. Now, when you first really started making money, what was your first car? What first car did you buy?
My first car was paying for my kids to go to private school and and college.
I heard that.
Yeah.
That's a big car.
But in actuality, I would say my first car that was like halfway decent was a BMW, like a 3 Series, 320, you know, nothing mm-hmm. too crazy.
Yeah.
But you know, it was an upgrade from the Chevy Cavalier or the Toyota Corolla, you know, yeah. so hey, I had to push that Toyota Corolla up the off ramp a couple of times trying to get home. You know, I was happy to have something that was more reliable. You know, and you know, and then I got like SUVs and stuff later and all that stuff. You know, but
yeah,
I never been like a flashy kind of person anyway.
That's
you know,
good. That's how you keep that money.
About making sure that the kids can have the opportunities that they need to have to fulfill their dreams, you know, because I've been fortunate enough to do what I love for a living. So mm-hmm. I wish that on everybody, you know, no yeah. matter what you do. Like, I hope that you can
preach,
find that passion
preach.
And do what you love, you know. Mm-hmm. That's more important than anything.
Yeah.
So before we go on to Shantanee in 60 seconds, one question. Out of all the people we named at the start of the show, Who did you actually get to meet? Did you get to meet Prince, Michael Jackson, Madonna, any of them? Some of the folks that you actually got to meet?
I got to meet Michael Jackson when he did his history album after I did the Remember the Time remix.
Yes.
Yeah.
He was working on his history album. And I actually went out there for 2 weeks and was working on tracks. And I saw Mike one time, but I did meet him. It was for a few seconds. Mm-hmm. He was, you know, he didn't have that many words, but he was like, you know.
How about Prince, Madonna, Jennifer?
Prince and Madonna didn't get to meet him, but Roberta Flack called me when her record went number one. I was like, wow, that's Roberta Flack, my father. I wish I could have him on the phone with me. Mm-hmm. That was one of his favorite artists. So for me to put one of his favorite artists on the dance charts, that was kind of different, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean that's why I always point to that record, because it kind of made me realize that I could be me mm-hmm. and do like some of those records that you were playing, like the Too Blind to See It and the you know, the Jamanda and just the Byron Stingily, the Ten City, That's the Way Love Is. That was me doing me. But before that, I didn't really know who I was. So, you know, it took me a while to figure that out. So those are big records for me to be able to do that. And then by the time I got to Prince and Michael Jackson, I already knew what my sound was, and I just did it. I just went in the studio and just went at it, you know. Mm-hmm. So at that point, I had a little bit of swagger at that point,
because right.
I realized that people actually were embracing what I was doing, so I didn't have to go to the A&R person and say, what do you think?
Yeah.
You know, they just said, do you, and then I was able to do me. So, you know, it takes a long time to get to that point where you can get everybody to believe in you, you know.
Yeah. So we're gonna play a game now. It's called Shantanee in 60 seconds. I'm gonna ask you a series of random questions. You have to answer them in 60 seconds or less. Don't pay attention to Clifton. He will try to distract you.
Okay.
Oh, I got a good one. I'm gonna distract him.
What was your first job?
It was at it was a paper route. your Chicago sometimes.
Your favorite artist to DJ?
Wait, favorite artist to DJ?
Yes, if you had to only DJ one artist at a party, who would it be?
Michael Jackson.
Name a lover gave you. What is a name that a lover has given you? He went out.
You got 60 seconds.
Daddy.
Yes, I love
it. Cat Daddy. Cat Daddy.
Cat Daddy.
Greatest piece of, what was the greatest piece of advice?
Kill him with kindness.
I was born in 1984. What were you doing then?
Smoking weed with me.
Oh my God.
I was on the radio on BMX and the Hot Mix 5 and DJing, living out my DJ dream, getting ready to start doing music.
If you could record or produce an album for a celebrity that is deceased, who would that be?
That would be Whitney Houston.
If you hadn't made a career in music, what would you have done instead?
I'd probably be a lawyer.
If you could live again as an animal, which one would it be?
Let me see. Who lives longest? Let me see.
Elephants.
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 I would be. If I could be. I guess I'd be a dog.
Which superpower?
They don't live too long.
Which superpower would you want? Invisibility, flying, or reading minds?
You said flying or
superpower,
reading minds?
Invisibility, flying, or reading minds. Which one?
Flying.
Who is your dream artist to work with today that you'd like to produce and mix for?
Drake?
I told you. I knew it. That was it. Right. See, that wasn't so bad.
Wasn't so bad.
Nope.
You don't remember us smoking weed. You don't remember us smoking weed together, but we were smoking.
No, Daddy.
If it was good weed, I wouldn't have remembered, right?
That's good answer, Steve. Good answer.
At this segment of the show, we're going to I'm going to come back to that one. The Dusty of the Week, and that's when we were smoking the Dusty.
We call it the Dusty. Dusty.
Anybody who knows me knows that one.
We call it the Dusty because you have to go down in your grandmother and your mama's basement and pull it off and blow the dust off it before you put it on the table.
So the Dusty tonight is brought to you by Sweet Events, SoCal Digital Magazine. That's right, sweet like this one. They got Tavis Smiley on it, KBLT Talk Radio. That's right. And download their app today and Sweet Life Magazine. Please go to register. It's a great magazine,
yes,
great articles. We're in there every month too. Yes, we are.
And we are.
Yes,
yeah,
we do.
We
are on it.
Okay.
Every month.
And they send out every week about.
I don't get my
25,000 subscribers.
I
have one in the car. I'll make sure you have it.
Oh, thank you. Because I thought it skipped me again as always.
We skip you like you skip.
So this, Steve. This is the Dusty I got tonight, man. Okay. You tell me, Jesse Saunders, On and On.
What are you saying about that?
We saying that's the Dusty of the Week. Jesse Saunders, On and On. That's like one of the first house songs down in the crates.
Okay.
Oh, you ain't know.
You want to say something?
No, I didn't. No. Do you know? You know it, right?
That's what I mean.
We're trying to say this is one of the earliest house songs. It's on record as being the first one.
That's one of the. I would say that was probably the first house pressing.
Okay, that's all I wanted to say. We thought
it was on wax, But the thing is, the reason there's a debate is because there was a lot of music that was influential to the house scene that was on cassette and reel to reel. Like you saw Frankie editing, and we all were editing. I used to put pieces of tape on the wall, but there was a lot of records that had impact, like Jamie Principle, Your Love, which was done in 82.
You got me. I wish we would have tried to find that one.
Yeah, but it didn't come out until it was bootlegged.
Okay.
So that's a whole different story. That could be a show in itself.
Absolutely. On who the first one was, I never believed there is a first. It evolved into a first commercial success. Yeah. But I always think about the first blues, the first anything.
The first Negro that stepped on this country, who was that, 16, 19? You was close to him, though.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
You know, I was in Jamestown on the low.
On the low.
I was on the low.
So On and On today
is our Dusty of the Week. And then after that, DJ Brad, you got something special for him? You got a little
video? Working on it.
Tony said nope.
He said no. No, we don't have that. So you might as well go to the next song. You said no, pretty Tony. So we can ready to close out with our last song, and this is the one with Chris Williams, Carolyn Griffey. Carolyn, this is for you.
Oh, thank you.
You want to talk about You're the One for Me, the collaboration you did with Steve, and was that Chris, when they say Christopher, was that Christopher Williams?
Yeah, it was Chris.
The funny thing. We looking for Chris. We looking for Chris Williams.
Yeah, we sure is.
That's Christopher. Yeah, you look. Nah, we looking. That's
yeah, all. Everybody stay looking for him.
Nah, he's the only guest we had
that never showed up.
It didn't show up
in we've 6 years.
Wow.
We had 216 guests,
and he's six the only
years.
One.
We looking for him.
Yeah.
You are kidding me.
But anyway, right. Let's talk about your song. Let's talk about your song.
Well, enough about him.
The funny thing is, I had been telling Chris. I mean, because I love D Train. I love the song. I've been telling Chris, you know, when Jaheim came and the comparisons and kind of, I just felt like that his voice and that song were just would really make an impact. He really wasn't into house music, and I had been listening to it, and of course with the guys and my relationship, and as I learned, just even traveling, seeing just what an impact it had all over the world and how many people, you know, it just made sense to me, and I've been asking him to do it forever, and he was just kind of blew me off. And one time I just said, Chris, you gotta do this song. He says, I'll do it if you do it with me. And I had been talking, you know, I've been working of course with SNS and of course Steven and Skip, and when we talked about it, they were like, man, that would be a great idea. But like you said, I was like, well, let me see if I can get him to do. I was really shocked when he wanted to do it, and he showed up.
So let's go ahead and introduce it as we close out the show.
Okay.
You're the one for me, right, Steve? Steve Silcock.
Right. Let's go.
But what they did to it.
Okay.
Jeez.
What they do to it, DJ Brad? Welcome back to the Groove Studios, and we're talking about Steve Silk Hurley. He done put that twist on it. He done put that twist on it. That SNS twist on it.
I just need to ask him a question.
All right. Yes.
I don't need to ask you a question, man. What is he saying? You know, D-Train saying at the beginning. He says he's gonna. You know, that's been the thing about what he actually said at the beginning.
On which part?
At the beginning of the song. Busta.
Busting out on the cloud.
What does it say?
Busting up on a cloud.
Is he busting up on a cloud? Right. No, that's not what we heard. We heard the other part. We ain't gonna say that.
Oh my God. This is a family show.
really? I mean, DJ's online has been going like,
We had that joke and we recorded it.
I've listened to it three or four and said, is he actually saying?
Might be.
Hey.
No.
No? Did you ask him?
I wasn't a part of that.
I wasn't there.
I'm washing my hands on that, okay?
Come on, Steve. What you got to say about that, man?
Busting up.
Busting up what?
Yeah.
You gonna stay on a cloud?
Okay.
You can stay with it.
You gonna stick with that?
He like took off up to the cloud. He busted up.
Yeah, I bet he did. I bet he did.
You need to listen to that thing again. You need to listen to it again.
Hey, so let's get it on for Sunday, November 7th in Los Angeles. We getting right. How they say it now? We gonna turn it up or is it lit? You know, I'm kind of slow. Yeah. Like, oh, Carolyn, what we doing on Sunday? We lit. We turning it up. What we doing?
We gonna turn it up, turn it out, get it lit.
Hey,
there you go.
It's my party.
Hey, it's a
I'm old. Look, I'm old school.
Hey, so we
ain't holding back.
We ain't holding back. So everybody gonna be in town. We're going to be there. Yep. We're going to be there at the Globe Theater. Get your tickets today because we're going to have everybody in the house, and it's going to be a party. We're going all night long. But as we do
on surprise guests.
And surprise guests. We keep saying surprise guests because we named a lot of folks. So I don't know who else going to be a surprise because we named a whole lot of folks.
Yeah.
Right. So
it's going to be some surprises coming up in there.
All right. Well, get there early. I'm telling you, get there early.
Yeah, get there early and catch the whole show.
So I'm gonna be there early. We gonna be there early, Shantani.
We gonna be there Saturday.
Oh, she said she's starting Saturday.
You starting Saturday at the club. You tell you.
But she said
I'll be there early. I'll be there early in the morning with that tent.
But what we do, man, when we have guests on the show, and like you said earlier, someone says give them their flowers
while they live. That's right.
So from Pretty Tony the engineer, DJ Reg, the consultant Robert A., Shantani and myself, we want to give you the We Love Rare Grooves Award, Mr. Steve Wright. So since I didn't get your address, we're going to have this here for you when you come in Sunday. I will present it to you. It doesn't have to be a big thing. I'll just give it to you backstage.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
All right. So this is for you and all the hard work that you put in since 19. Yeah, you can feel it since 1977.
Now, you got to put it on the wall. Don't use it as a paperweight, okay?
Yeah,
you
put it right next to you. Yeah.
No, that's a dope one there. That's cool.
Yeah, and it's an open mic. It's an open mic.
Yeah.
So
I like that.
Carolyn and Carrie, you got to come back on. And when you come
get
back
yours.
On,
get yours,
all right?
So,
we love to be honored. Thank you. Ben, thank you for letting us be a part of this, Steve. We love you. Appreciate you. And so now you know I'm a fan. Secrets out.
Hey, and I appreciate y'all being here.
One thing.
When is it about me?
So, Steve, are you broadcasting? Are you streaming anything, you know? DJ.
No, not right now. I'm not. We've been focusing on the label. I got an anthology of my greatest hits coming out that we're trying to, we've been saying we're going to put it out for the last year. You know, the pandemic hit. We kind of put things on hold a little bit, but we're getting ready to start releasing. We're going to release them in volumes. We decided to just go ahead and do that because otherwise we'll be like, wait, but what about that? So we're going to drop volume one probably at the beginning of the year.
Can you do a world premiere on We Love Rare Grooves?
I'll
be looking
and
for
we need,
you.
And we need a video too, man. Right. I'm a video DJ and I stream on Twitch. So let's think it was
going. Okay.
He had a special DJ. He had a video for you.
I did it too. I did it, but you know, but it's gonna. I gotta get it to. Gotta get it to the man over there to get it to him. It's gonna take a second.
All right, so we'll download it and send it to you through.
We'll get it to you.
No, we'll get it to you. So we always do a video presentation for our guests. You know, we do our research and find it. Yeah. So as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves, we're going to see everybody Sunday night at the Globe Theater. That's right, Randy. We're going to get folks down there, right? We're going to partay.
What time?
DMJ.
What time?
RDMJ Entertainment.
Starts at 8.
Starts at 8? Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
I'll be there at 7:15.
Carolyn said she's going to be there Saturday, so y'all better, you know.
I'll be there with the tent on Saturday.
With the tent. Yeah, we've been in the tent.
Go online for ctickets.us. Man, we're going to have a good time, though. I'm a house head. Man, I used to be in my part when I used to be in D.C. at Tracks on Wednesday night because that was straight night and no pun intended. And it was straight.
Oh, my God. There was no was, pun.
Right, it was straight night and we would leave there at 6 o'clock in the morning and go to work. That's when we was going hard. We're going hard. So as we do here on We Love Rare Groove, next week, who do we have in the groove studio, gang? Wow, don't nobody know but me, Shirley Murdoch.
Oh, Shirley Murdoch.
We know now.
That was a surprise. I didn't know that.
Hey, maybe no telling what I guess nowadays.
Right. I know.
Out of Dayton, Ohio, I need that.
We'll let you have that
Shirley
one.
Shirley Murdoch?
Ohio. I like Dayton. Dayton is good. Yeah.
What were those hits she had?
O-H-I-O.
She had husband and husband and...
A lot of funk coming out of Dayton, Ohio.
There you go.
That's true.
But we had a lot of funk tonight.
She sang with Roger.
And she did, didn't she?
In the beginning,
she then she did a little gospel, too.
Yeah. We're going to have all that next week.
Oh, okay. All right,
Mr. Hurley, there you go.
Mr. Hurley.
We love Rare Grooves, Mr. Hurley. We got Carolyn Griffin. We got Carrie Lucas. We threw out some of that music tonight. And we look forward to coming back and having you ladies as special guests on the show.
Please.
Going through that. And find a replay of our show will be up on our YouTube channel.
Follow us on Instagram, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify. Audio versions of the show will be there in their entirety. Thank you guys so much for your support, and thank you for voting for us.
Hey, call DJ Raz for your holiday party. That's right.
He's please call
him. Call him today. You can call us, and we'll make sure you get in touch with DJ Raz. But please subscribe to our show. We want to thank everyone again for voting for us for Best Music Podcast. Elda, you know what? We are in consideration. We're in consideration. Not for a Grammy, but for Image.
NAACP.
NAACP.
That's what I said.
Award.
NAACP Image Award.
Yep. Because they have a podcast category now.
I'm listening to that part again. I don't know about you guys saying that.
Hey, but it's been fun. Thank you so much for joining us. Hey, Randy, thank you so much for getting them here on the show. We had a great time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm going to see you all on Sunday, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, we love you, Randy.
I heard you. I heard.
See all of y'all.
All right, we're going to be there, man. Well, we got to see you. Right?
We got you.
Only as we do here on
We Love Rare Grooves.
Pretty Tony. Give me some more of that.
Good night, everybody.
Soulful Sunday. Come on down.
From Los Angeles, Sunday, November 7th, RDMJ Soulful Sundays live in SNS Chicago presents The SNS Experience, Steve Shukurly's Birthday Bash, featuring CeCe Peniston, Byron Stingily of 10 City, Steve Shukurly, David Harness, DJ Skip, Man Wilson and Sean Christopher, Mellow Man 8, Carrie Lucas, Carolyn Griffey, Lee Farmer, Randall Dean, DJ 3J, David Sabat, Derek Wise, and special surprise guests you don't want to miss. This event will be hosted by MDoc and George Daniels, Sunday, November 7th, 9 p.m. till 4 a.m. at the Globe Theater, 740 Broadway in downtown L.A. Tickets are available at evenbright.com and ctickets.us. Do you remember?